Hey guys, I'm Aussie Villa. Welcome to episode 10 of Bali United. Episode 10 already. Time flies, doesn't it? And we start in the medical centre, and that's never a good thing, is it? And we start in the medical centre because Boaz, our beloved Boaz, has picked up a torn groin muscle. He's out for another 6 weeks, 3 to 6 weeks. At the time, it was 2 months that he did the injury. So that's not great because he is just that little bit of touch of class, isn't he, that we perhaps lack elsewhere in the squad. So we're going to miss him. 15 finishing, we're really going to miss that, aren't we? But anyway, Boaz is done. He will be back. It's not a career-ending injury or anything, but it's not great nonetheless. And the other problem we have is that Remus has picked himself up an injury. Now, he's about another 2 weeks away or so. Now, the big problem with Remus, now he's, of course, our first-choice goalkeeper. The big problem with Remus being injured is that our second-choice goalkeeper has joined him on the injured list. Now, we have a third goalkeeper who, to be fair, is about at the same level as this guy. This guy's a little bit higher potential, so he will sort of the guy I'm hoping will stay long term. He has a cap for Indonesia, believe it or not, as well. So, you know, that is what it is, I guess. But yeah, not ideal to have so many injuries. The other injury you can see, oh, you probably can't because it's behind my head. Lily Pally's picked up a minor injury. He'll miss this first game, but he'll be back for the second one. Today we have, of course, the second leg of our Interzone Playoff Asian Confederation Cup. I think I got everything in there. We're already 5-0 up, so we're going to play some reserves. Keep anybody on a booking out of that one. So give us a chance to see some of the backup players. Then we have the big derby against Mitra Kukar in the league. But before we get to any of that, let's have a look and see how we've been going since last episode, starting with the Indonesian Cup second round tie, first leg against Persib. Defeat got us off to the perfect start after 62 seconds, before doubling our joy in the 5th minute from the spot. 30 minutes in and we were in heaven as Tafik completed his hat-trick. Persib pulled one back late on in the first half. But this was Tafik's half and Saghara picked him out for his fourth goal of the opening 45 minutes. Persib got a second on the hour mark, but we regained our 3-goal margin when Lily Pally threaded a ball into Hamdi. So there you go, it was a really, really good performance as well. This is where Boaz got injured. Tafik, absolute god amongst men this game. He just continues to, he's to get it now and again, just these players that defy their attributes. And Tafik is definitely one of those guys. 4 goals, it was a club record. I think it was a competition record as well. So that was amazing. Now, of course, if you remember, we had all of our internationals called up. They were going to miss the second leg. 5-2 was a good lead. It gave us a chance. Did we hang on? Hamdi put aside any thoughts of a Persib comeback, pouncing on an early error, before Melbourne added a second early goal, thanks to more defensive hesitation. Persib pulled one back from the spot, but Milana Putra produced a wonder strike to restore our lead before the break. Persib got a second goal of the match with a good finish, but we had the final say late on, thanks to Kayami. So there you go, comfortable in the end, 9-4 on aggregate. It's like a tennis score, isn't it? It's more than a tennis score. We looked really good at times in this game. There was a few moments defensively we didn't look so good. But Hamdi, Melvin, Mulana Putra, who is of course the guy that I'm trying to retrain as a centre-back. We played him in midfield on this one just because, you know, we were lacking some numbers. But what a goal that was. And Kayami as well continues to just be a superstar for us. So after this we had a league fixture against Perseru. I think it was away from home. Kayami gave us the lead late in the first half, latching on to a loose ball. But our lead didn't last long as we fell asleep from a corner a minute later. We fell behind on the hour mark, but Melvin drew us level a few minutes later with a calm finish. We were behind again 5 minutes later, but Kayami rescued us a point late on, turning in a Nuri cross. And that sums up Bali United this year pretty much perfectly. We looked so good going forward at times, and we looked horrible at the back. Kayami with a double, Melvin with a goal as well. You can see it was a relatively even game. I'd like to say we should have held on, having you know, been in front there, but to score so late on to get that extra point, you know, it's, yeah, I mean, it is what it is, isn't it? It was a back and forth game. And in the end, a draw was probably just about fair. But again, I would have liked to have got the win there. So if we have a look at what all that means for the league table, we are top by a single point now. No more game in hand. That was our game in hand against Perseru. We've got our next opponent in the Indonesian Cup. Now, it's not important. This mob are sort of a non-league, so sort of third tier or below So you'd like to think that we'd be able to see them off, having, of course, seen off two League One teams so far. So it's about time we got a bit of a softer draw. So there we go. But today, to start with, it's all about this game right here against Bengaluru, I guess you'd pronounce that, Bengaluru. The Indian team, of course, and we are the Indonesian team, which is not confusing at all. We are the favourites this one. You would expect that, having won the first leg 5-0. Quick refresher, we know absolutely nothing about them, which is nice. And this is the team that we are sending out. Now, like I said, anybody that is on a booking or booking away from a suspension, they're nowhere near this starting lineup. At 5-0, we do not need to be sort of losing players to silly second booking. So we're going to go with Henwarden in goal. This is the goalkeeper we have that is fully fit. The other two are coming back, but you can see he's okay. There's a lot of nines in there, which I think, you know, it's makes it look a little bit worse. But he's 35, so he's not getting any better. We're gonna give we're gonna give Ora another game. Now, if you remember, he played up, was it a 5.1 last episode? So hopefully we'll see an improvement on that. He should be. He's better than that. So he has played one game since and did okay. It's going to be Doki and Kayo in midfield, midfield and centre of defence with Letsonen. Siatabadi, I've got to get these names. Siatabudi is going to sit in there as a halfback role. Tafik, goal-scoring machine that is, and Siswanto will go in midfield. Paolo Sergio coming back from injury. We're not going to get 90 minutes out of it. We'll try and get as many as we can. I don't know that I want Maliafeni on the bench, actually, if he's on a booking. Is there anybody else we can put in there to give him a break? So we'll go with Paolo Sergio and Kayami. It's going to be Batchdom up top. He's a more natural striker. Let's see how he does. So we can see the way they're lining up. I think that's different to how they played last time, isn't it? But, you know, it should be fine. It doesn't really matter, does it? At 5-0, it shouldn't matter. Don't need to overcomplicate things. Boys, this is a different game. We're starting from scratch. That seems to have gained some focus. Let's go with some passion and we have faith. See if we can fire him up just a little bit. And let's get out there and let's see what some of the backup players can do. I'm curious to see how Batchdom does as a striker. I'll be honest, he's on very, very thin ice. You can see he's a good player at this level, which I'm just not getting the best out of him. I'm not going to blame you guys for it, so we're not. I'm just not getting the best out of him right now. So we'll just have to see how he goes. Tafik! Oh, warning shots there early on. So, yeah, that's good to see. I want to just try and get maybe like 45. We'll see how Sergio gets into sort of the low 70s, we're going to take him off. I don't want to injure him again, but this is a good opportunity in sort of a non-competitive game to give him some game time. And just try and get him back to fitness, because he is an important player for us. Maliafeni is great, but I don't quite think he's at the level of Paolo Sergio, and you need two players for each position in any case. It's a good ball to find Tafik in space. Just not quite on the same wavelength there. And a lump forward, is it going to catch us out? We've got three men back, but they are getting forward quicker than we are getting back. Ball into the back post, and that is off the crossbar. Oh, that was surely supposed to be 1-0. Here goes Batchdom now, other end. It's like a game of basketball, end to end. And that will surely end the highlights. Looking frustrated and complacent. We'll give them a concentrate. I mean, when your pre-game team talk is don't, you know, concentrate here, boys. You don't like to see this. Tafik's tracking back well there and won that. Tafik is quickly coming into reckoning to be one of sort of a first choice starting player. He just is getting the job done. Makes me regret almost signing Siswanto, but he's had some good games for us as well. We should, after this, have our under-23s back. There's a good-looking ball in. Kayami's there! Oh, he's just past the post. So Hadriadi, Adsit, and who was the other one that went off with the under-23s? I can't remember who it was now. But they should all be back after this game. I'm expecting that their time with the under-23s will be up. So that's good news. Anything else I'm trying to think? Oh, but there was a left-back that was gone too, wasn't it? It was Farjan, I think, wasn't it? That's who the other guy was. So, you know, that will be back pretty much to full strength then after international call. Here you go, Paolo Sergio! Another time there. Just not quite on it. Look, we have a whole team full of complacent players. I don't really know what to say to that. Look at Tafik there. Done well to win that. Kayami, Batchdom. Oh, it's a penalty. Paolo Sergio will step up to take it. It was just clumsy defending, wasn't it? I tell you what, this is how we play when we're complacent. More complacency, please, boys. That's horrible. Paolo Sergio has put it straight through the goalkeeper. Apparently, Casper's in goal for them. And that is one goal. It's the away goal. If there was any chance of a comeback, what is the goalkeeper doing? It's almost hitting clean in the nose. If there's any chance of a comeback, that has surely taken that out. And there we go again. Oh, it's offside. Was it going in before Kayami put the touch on it? Have a look here. It was close, wasn't it? It was Batchdom. Was it going in? We're not going to see, are we? Oh, I think it was. I think Kayami's stolen a goal from Batchdom, and he's offside. He's ended up getting it ruled off. Let's try praising them. See, there we go. That fires them up. It says a little bit about their mental state, doesn't it? They can place it until they get told they're good. So yeah, here we go. Aura is playing a 6.9 now. He just had a bad day that last time out, we'll say. We'll give him the benefit of the doubt there. I mean, we've been okay without being great, to be honest. They're not coming back, are they? Let's just say they're doing really well and get back out there. Double substitution from our Indian friends, but it's unlikely to make a difference now. They're playing the same way. Yes, they are. We're still complacent and disinterested and all those sort of great things that you love to see. What do we want to do here? How's Sergio's doing okay? Is there anybody on the bench we want to give game time to? Not necessarily. Here we go with Tafik from a free kick. And again, just over the bar. We're looking okay, aren't we? We're dominating the game again. We just don't quite have the same level of finishing that we had in the first leg. But, I mean, we don't necessarily have to. We've also got a lot of reserves out. I don't think we've seen enough from Batchdom here, have we, really, to say that. Not that we don't want to keep, I do want to keep him, but it's just, come on, man. That's not the best defending we'll see. I'm actually kind of annoyed at sort of the mental state of the team. You know, it's complacent and disinterested and all that kind of stuff. It's not what we need, is it? Let's concentrate, please, boys. Bit of bad defending, and I mean, you can't really blame the keeper for that. Look at this, disinterested and all that. I'm gonna try Batchdom. Let's see what other roles can you play here. Let's try maybe the deep lying forward. I want to try and get something out of him, because like I keep saying, he is a good player for this level. So I mean, he's an Indonesian international as well, and he was playing for Indonesia when they got called up as well. So you know, he is actually an Indonesian international. Let's not push Paulo Sergio any further, and Tafik's looking a little bit tired there, so let's bring on Maulana Putra for him. And just kind of count down to the end of the game here now. 1-1 on the night's a little bit disappointing, isn't it? But, you know, when you've come in at 5-0, you've rested majority of your good players, or first choice players anyway, you know, it's not a bad result to get. Miku just past the post again. We'll get this final. Hopefully that can be next episode. It was pretty tight between the Kyrgyzstani team and the North Korean team. It would be nice to go give Kim Jong-un a little bit of a visit, wouldn't it? The problem is that if we beat his team, do we leave the country? That could be perhaps the the problem with playing them. They've lumped one forward. It'd be really disappointing to lose on the night, wouldn't it? Aura's done okay there. And this is looking a little bit like an end-of-game highlight now. It's never really got going, this game, to be honest. But there it is. We're into the final, which is excellent stuff. We didn't pick up any bookings, just the one for Kayo. That may put him at risk. But it was an even game. We dominated possession. It was kind of an even game. We dominated possession quite a bit. I'm going to tell them, boys, that was a bit of a... Just don't get complacent. So first leg triumph helps Bali, just a small help, 5-0, you know, I wouldn't say it was done there, but, you know, there we go. So here we go, we are playing the North Korean team, Hwabu Sports Group, in the final. Now, is it a one-off final, or is it a two-legged affair? It is looking like a two-legged affair, doesn't it? What do we want to do here, rules? I really wish it would just send you to the right screen there. All right, so it's a two-legged affair. So we have the first leg at home, which worked okay for us this time, but we want to make sure we're getting the job done properly, don't we, in the first leg, and not have any... You know, we don't have work to do going to North Korea. But guys, wait right there. We'll be back for the big derby now against Mitra Kukar in League One. Okay, welcome back. There is breaking transfer news. We've made a signing ahead of next season. Terence Perini is his name. He's a winger. He can play on the left or the right. I know we already have some good wingers, but this guy, look at that, he's absolutely rapid. Absolutely rapid. He's got good dribbling and crossing for this level as well. Everything else we can work on. Flair's not too bad. Composure's not too bad either. Technique's there as well. Basically, passing's horrible. We're going to need to do some passing training. Basically, I mean, this guy is just so rapid at this level. I just think that is worth maybe at, you know, 2 or 3 points in every other attribute. So Let me know what you think. He's 64 rated by the scouts is pretty good, to be honest, compared to what else we've seen. Yeah, I mean, he's young, he's Indonesian. It's important that we do sign the best Indonesian players that we can so that we can then use foreign slots to sort of fill in the gaps. I think his pace is going to cause problems. And hopefully, I'm hoping even in the Champions League, you know, when we go up against the best teams in Asia, should we get there, of course, that, you know, that pace is going to cause trouble. And like I said, he's adequate to good, even at Champions League level in Asia, I would imagine, with 10 and 10 with that pace. So I think that's going to be good. The deal, it was a little bit expensive for us, if we can see here. Well, it's not too bad. 60K up front, is it going to stay here? That's his contract. So he's actually on very, very reasonable wages. The fee, it's 60 grand, rising up to 165. I think it was like, it was money for 50 goals, 50 games. And I think if we like made the semifinals of the Champions League or something. So let me know what you think. That is Terence Pohini. I do think that there's a very good player in there for us for next season. But this is what we're worried about right now. It's the derby against Mitra Kukar. Now, they are struggling this year. They are all the way down at the bottom of the table. PS Tira have already played this weekend. They've already won. So they go 2 points ahead of us. So it's important that we win to go back ahead of them. Their manager here is Emeril Abrus. He is decent enough, I'd say, but for this level. He's only been in charge for about 2 months, so he's a new manager. They're a balanced, standard playing style. Let's have a look at the team that we're sending out. It is same goalkeeper, Hedrawan in goal. It is Angga Putra, it's Kayo, Pacheco, and Latsinen as the back four. Nuri comes back in to play the halfback role. Siswanto and Melvin in midfield. It's Malafeni and Kayami with Spasojevic up top. There we go. They are lining up. That's more or less, I think, how we're expecting them to line up. Which is good, hopefully, with their number 10. Hopefully, Nuri will sort of cancel him out. We'll have a little bit more space to attack into. Assistant says, do it for the fans. I'm going to say, what am I going to say? What am I going to say? Oh, I do it for the fans. Let's give the fans a performance they're expecting of us here. Some passionate, we have faith in you, boys. Go out there and put on a display, or at least just defend well. I have sort of, whoa, that's a huge stadium. Why can't we play in this one? That is absolutely massive for a local derby. It's huge. What was I saying? Oh, yeah, training. So I have kind of got into, gone through training for the next few months, sort of doing 1 week defense, 1 week something else, just to try and make sure that we're you know, solid defensively, because I think what we've seen is that we, oh, that's not good, is it? We do tend to have a goal in us. We've just seen there, we do have a bit of a defensive howler in us as well. So we'll need to do some more work on defending corners. There was men there, it was just beating the men on the post. I'm thinking, mate, you could have done a little bit better, Spasojevic, if I'm honest, rather than just kind of stand there and watch it go over your head. Come on, boy, show some passion here. So that's our training regime right now. Maybe we could do some attacking play as well. Come on, boys, demand more. So this is going well. We've injured somebody. That's something, I guess. All right, let's take it off, exploit the flanks. I'm still really, really working hard trying to get a data analysis in. See, given that they built me a data analysis facility, you know, to try and get somebody in to sit in there and do something with it. That's horrible defending again. Boys, what are we doing? It makes you wonder why you even bother training. Why don't we just all have the week off? I'd rather go sit on a beach in Bali anyway. And we can just work on our tans and then just come together and get laughed at as we try and defend against bottom of the table. Come on, boys. So the halftime team talk's not going to be a nice one, is it? That is unbelievable. I cannot believe what we've just seen there. Your pride is at stake. You're letting yourselves down. I guess, you know, we have to just kind of, you're capable of better here, boys. I have faith in you. No one's listening to me. No one cares. You're capable of more. We're going to have to make changes here, aren't we? We're going to have to just sub you all off. We've got a little bit of something there. Let's see what we get out of the second half here. Let's give it an encourage, I guess. Just can we try, please, boys, and do something here? I mean, there's been no highlights outside of the set-piece goals. Here we go, Spasojevic. That's always looked like it was going over. And we're making changes. We're making changes. We're going to bring Paolo Sergio on the left because Kayami is just having a bad day. We're going to bring Tafik on for Siswanto. And we're going to bring on... No, we'll leave Melvin on. The fullbacks are just having bad days, aren't they? Let's try and bomb them on a little bit more. See if we can get an overlap or something. All right, come on, boys. Come on. Show me something. Some sort of signs of life here, please. We'll give her a demand more, but I have a bad feeling about this, to be honest. I mean, this is bottom of the league, guys. Come on. Here we go. Paolo Sergio. What's he got for us? He lumps one forward to absolutely nobody. I don't even know what... I do not know what to say to them. Let's maybe lower the tempo. Maybe we're trying to do things a little bit too quickly here. We need to try and get ourselves back into this game, though, don't we? If we go down another goal, then it is... We are in all sorts of trouble. Oh, it's off the crossbar. I mean, there's still, what, 35 minutes to go. There's plenty of time if we learn how to pass to each other and do something. But otherwise, it's looking a little bit sketchy here. Come on, boys. Get a tackle in. We're going to have to change everything about the way we're playing here, aren't we? We're going to have to... Oh, it's a good tackle there. Can we go on? Here we go. Go on, Melvin. What's he got for us? A little bit of quality. He just lumps it forward. Spasojevic is there, though. He gets him to lump. Look at the back post. Look at the back post. It's there. It's Paolo Sergio. And that's a good goal. A really good counter-attacking goal. Love that. 10th of the year for Paolo Sergio. He was... Look at that. He was doing his best to get up there. It was a decent pass, wasn't it, to be fair, from Melvin. Spasojevic just done. Well, not just to see him, but then to pick him out as well. That is stunning and a good finish from Paolo Sergio. 2-1. We're back in this derby, boys. Come on, push forward. Let's go get another one. Let's go get another one. While they're low and their confidence is rattled. Come on. Here we go. Engelputra throw in for Spasojevic. There for Paolo Sergio. Back for Spasojevic. Look at the Melvin. Melvin's in so much space and we just needed to lower the tempo. We were trying to do things too quickly. And look what's happened since we've lowered it. It's 2-2. Two goals in 5 minutes. Excellent stuff. Let's tell them to concentrate. We don't want to get too excited here, but, you know, it's time to be a little bit excited. Look at that. It's a well-picked down. Look at that finish from Melvin. That's what we need. A little bit of quality in the middle of the box there. And that is what, as I said, we do like to see. All right, can we complete this comeback now, boys? Come on. Come on, come on, come on. Let's push forward. Let's go get this winner. Engelputra's having a bad game at left back, so let's bring Aura on. Yeah, let's do that. Here we go. If we concede from another set piece, I'm going to lose my crap. Oh, good save from Head Jordan or whatever his name is. Come on. Keep your concentration here, boys. Keep your concentration. Let's go get a counter-attacking goal here. Head clear. Lump it for Spasojevic. There we go. Melbourne heads clear. Lump it, lump it. Nope. Right, keep concentrating on your defending, boys. Oh, what a block that is from Kayo. Stunning, stunning block. And again, this is more like it, boys. This is the defense we want to see from you. Come on, come on. Let's give him some praise. Come on, can we praise them forward? Oh, don't be a draw. Don't be a draw. It's going to be a draw. It's going to be a draw. Oh, silly, silly drop points in the derby. I mean, in the end, we dominated the game, didn't we? It's just... conceding from set pieces, we couldn't come back. The effort was not excellent. It was not excellent. I'm sorry. It was you've done well. It was a good comeback. You've done well, but it was not excellent. So there we go. Mitra Kukar, hold on for draw. That's not the result that we needed from that game. To be fair, it wasn't a stunning episode. Sorry about that, guys. Not the way that you want your weekend to go, is it? But it now leaves us a point behind of PS Tira. Yeah, we're going to have to do defensive set-piece work here, aren't we? So while we're doing defense... you don't deserve a rest tomorrow, boys. You're going to come in, you're going to do some defending of free kicks, and then we're going to do some defending of corners as well. This is just a cup game, so I'm not too worried about it. Actually, you know what? We might rest them there. We don't want to injure people here, do we? And you can come in this day and do it. Your defensive corners work. There we go. All right. Yes, I do want to change that. That is it for today, though, guys. If you have enjoyed that, for whatever reason, we got through. And that's the main thing, isn't it? We did get through. Do make sure you hit thumbs up. Subscribe if you're new. And I will see you next time for the first leg of the final. And then we'll do Persija, is it? They're 17th in the league away from home. We've just seen we've only got a draw from 18th. So there's no such thing as an easy game when you have our defense, unfortunately. Guys, that's all. As I said, I'll see you next time. Take care.